Hello there. This is Cal Krishnan, and I had the pleasure of watching and photographing the 2024 total solar eclipse from the home of my niece in Toledo, Ohio. This is a slideshow of the pictures I took, along with some narration as to what you're seeing. We start this slideshow at the point of first contact called C1. This is when the moon is just grazing the sun from our point of view. The moon is not seen in the picture because, after all, this is a new moon day. As you can see, it's a fairly hazy day with high clouds. The solar disk is still distinctly visible, and you can see some sunspots on it as well if you look closely. We will talk about those sunspots later in this slideshow. At this point, the moon is starting its approach from the bottom right. We will watch it as it creeps up and to the left, obscuring more and more of the sun. This is the final picture before the moon fully obscures the sun, which is called C2. At C2, the solar filter is taken off and the total eclipse phase begins. Here we are, the first glimpse of totality. In this picture, a very tiny speck of the sun's photosphere, which is the part that shines, is still visible. This causes this beautiful effect, which is called diamond ring effect. We will watch as the diamond becomes smaller and smaller in the next couple of pictures. Now, the sun has entirely disappeared behind the moon. Yet, some sunlight seeps through the many valleys between the mountains on the moon. These produce a string of bright spots at the top right of the picture, and this is called Bailey's beads. We can see at least four distinct beads in this picture. Just for fun, I superposed the photograph of the full sun that you saw before as a ghostly image behind the moon. The sun is about 400 times larger than the moon, but because the distance of the moon from the Earth is almost exactly 1/400th of the distance to the sun, these two disks are very close to the same size. This is a remarkable cosmic coincidence that makes such solar eclipses possible. However, the size is not identical. The moon appears slightly larger than the sun. You can also see that the solar disk is positioned slightly right of top of the moon, so you can see the Bailey's beads there and nowhere else. Here we focus on the chromosphere of the sun. The sun's atmosphere has three distinct regions: the photosphere, the chromosphere, and the corona. The photosphere is the one that puts out the light that we call sunshine. The chromosphere has this distinct red coloration that you can see in this picture, which comes from ionized hydrogen. Since the sun is closest to the moon's edge, slightly right of top, as seen in the last picture, this is where we see the chromosphere most distinctly. There are distinctive features in the chromosphere called solar prominences. These are composed of reddish plasma and magnetic fields that rise up from the photosphere, up through the chromosphere, and the corona, and often fall back to form loops. In this picture, we see several beautiful examples. I especially love the one that is in the 3 o'clock position that has a wispy character. We see more prominences top right because that's where the solar disk is closest to the lunar disk, as noted before. But do note the one that is at the 5 o'clock position. The solar disk is very far from the lunar disk there. So that must be one massive prominence to be visible. Here is a photo of the solar corona. This is the upper atmosphere of the sun that extends millions of miles above the photosphere. This is only visible to us during the eclipse, as it is otherwise washed out by the glare of the photosphere. The dark and bright structures visible here are formed by the plasma that is channeled by the sun's magnetic field. The moon is moving on, and the sun's photosphere is starting to peek out to form another diamond ring. You can see several Bailey's beads here as well, as the moon's surface starts to break up the sunlight through its valleys. This was an especially beautiful extended diamond presentation as the moon exited. This gives way to the brilliance of the massive diamond as the moon progresses. The totality is over. The solar filter is on, and we watch the moon slowly roll away from the sun. By the way, the percentages are based on time and not the actual coverage of the sun by the moon. The eclipse is over and the sun has fully emerged. The high clouds parted too, of course, so this picture has none of the haze present in the beginning picture. You can also see the sunspots distinctly. One final science note, NASA numbers and tracks these sunspots, and I have shown the more prominent ones in this overlay. I also show a scale below so you can see how large these sunspots are. The one numbered 3628 is large enough to swallow several Earths into it. Thanks for watching this slideshow. I hope you enjoyed it and learned something too. Bye-bye.